Well, my question was for Mr. Sherman, since this was, this was his plan, and it's a great plan, and I applaud him for raising the money. However, the question is this, since he represents the city, and if anybody here represents him, there are several private entities, religious entities, that are willing to step up and open shelters and provide shelter, and the city seems to be the obstacle, you know. I don't know if anybody can answer that or take that question to him, why is the city such an obstacle when it comes to caring for homeless?
Well, just one thing. Supervisor Sherman is actually with the county, and it's overlapped because, you know, the river area is the county park that's in the city, so the city and county tend to be involved in this thing. And I don't know, I mean, without specific, you know, several things like that to address, but, you know, the city's a stickler about having your permits and your codes, and they worry about health and safety as well. I can tell you with that.
Karen, thanks for your question. I'd like to remind everyone we are a little pressed for time, but we keep our questions short to the point. Before the gentleman in the second row, we did have a hand up in the back row of the question. If you could stand.
Yeah, you have your clothes on your back and you go into the shelter. Is there a safe place to store your belongings?
In this case, yes. These 32 beds, Salvation Army is going to provide storage.
What about winter overflow?
Yes.
Winter sanctuary, yes. We can store your stuff there. We store people's stuff every night. We leave it in the staging area, and then we pick it up in the morning.